We are in the chapter winds and storms. In the previous videos, we have discussed two major types of storms, cyclones and thunderstorms. In this video, we are going to discuss on tornadoes. On your screen, you can see the funnel shaped storm over there, isn't it? So this funnel shaped storm is generally referred as a tornado. Now we know that cyclones are formed over oceans. Thunderstorms are usually formed over land, isn't it? But tornadoes are, you know, going to be there in the category of thunderstorms. These tornadoes are also formed on land, okay? Yes, the contribution of water bodies is definitely there, okay? But mostly they are formed over lands, okay? Now these tornadoes are formed from thunderstorms. So first there would be formation of thunderstorm cloud or clouds, and from those thunderstorm clouds tornado is going to arise, right? So let us see about tornadoes. Tornadoes are very fast moving, spinning, funnel shaped columns of winds. Okay, you might have seen in the previous slide how the wind is there. It is in the form of a funnel. Okay, it's a big column or long column of winds. And how these winds are moving? They are spinning, and they are spinning at a very faster rate. So that we have said that tornadoes are very fast moving, spinning, funnel shaped columns of winds. Now these tornadoes are produced from thunderstorm clouds. Now these tornadoes keep rotating while maintaining the contact with the both clouds and the surface of the earth. In the previous slide, you have seen that the funnel shaped thunderstorm is in contact with the sky at one end and sea here, and it is in the contact with the surface of the earth at the other end. Okay, so these funnel shaped rotating storms are known as tornadoes. Now these tornadoes are really very dangerous. These storms can be several miles wide and have wind speeds as fast as 300 miles per hour. They have indiscriminate and unpredictable travel routes and act like giant vacuum cleaners, picking up everything in their paths. So they are really, really dangerous. How do tornadoes form? Well, I told you before that tornadoes are formed from thunderstorm clouds, isn't it? The exact theory regarding formation of tornadoes is not available, but generally all the scientists believe in the fact that yes, tornadoes are going to arise from thunderstorm clouds. Okay, now we know how thunderstorms are formed. Okay, there would be heating up of air, the warm air will rise up, it takes a lot of moisture along with it, the air then cools down, water vapors are condensed, and a big cloud is formed. Okay, and this cloud will keep on going up and up in the atmosphere, and again the warm air will continue to rise up and more such clouds are formed. Okay, now here comes the formation of tornadoes. How? When, if there is a change in wind direction and wind speed at high altitudes, then the air will start swirling. Okay, there will be spinning or swirling of the air. When cold air and warm air, hot air mixes, and because of the change in the direction of those winds and their speed, difference in their speeds, the air will now start swirling horizontally, or it will start spinning, okay, horizontally, right? And this funnel of swirling air begins to suck up more warm air from the ground, and the funnel grows longer and longer, and it stretches forward to the ground. And when the funnel touches to the ground, it becomes a tornado. Now, what are the characteristics of tornado? Well, the tornadoes have a typical narrow funnel shape. Okay, it starts from clouds and reaches down to the ground. The size of tornadoes vary widely. A typical tornado in the United States is around 500 feet across, but some may be as narrow as just a few feet across or nearly 2 miles wide. Okay, so it depends. Now, what would be the wind speed? The wind speed of a tornado can vary from 65 miles per hour to 250 miles per hour. Now the color of the tornado. The tornadoes may appear different in colors depending upon the local environment. Some may be nearly invisible, while some others may appear white, gray, black, blue, red, or even green. So it depends on the local environmental conditions. Now, where do most tornadoes occur? See, in previous videos we have seen the different locations of cyclones, isn't it? Like that, tornadoes are also predominantly occurring in some areas, okay, some parts of world. The tornadoes are most common in United States, and these tornadoes are going to occur in an area called Tornado Alley. Tornado Alley stretches from northern Texas to South Dakota and from Missouri to the Rocky Mountains. So this is the region which is more prone to tornadoes. Now, what are the destructions caused by tornadoes? Well, there are many, but let us list out a few of them. It results in flash floods and hail. It causes uprooting large number of trees, you know, roofs of houses, cars, trucks, and even it may take life of individuals. Okay, it would also be dangerous to animals. Okay, now, what are the precautions to be taken during tornadoes? Well, go to the basement or an inside room without windows on the lowest floor. Okay. Then avoid vehicles and do not stand near trees, because we have seen that these tornadoes are going to work as, you know, act as vacuum cleaners. They would, you know, uproot a tree and all those trees, vehicles are just dragged away. If you are outdoors, you should lie down near a depression and protect yourself from debris. Now let us talk about certain precautions to be taken by government and people during, before, and after the storms. Government should forecast cyclones or storms at least 24 hours in advance with the help of satellites and radars. Shelters should be made, of course, they should be made away from the coast, with underground rooms. When a storm like cyclone or a tornado strikes, individuals should take shelter under tables, bow down, and protect their heads and necks using their arms. Okay, so head and neck region should be protected using your arms. Okay, necessary food items and medicines should be stocked in case of any such warning. Fishermen should not venture into the sea. Never ignore warnings from meteorological department. Avoid driving on waterlogged roads. Cooperate and help others during such situations. And always help the rescue team. And now, my dear students, we have finished with our chapter Winds and Storms. And see which major points we have covered. We have seen the meaning of air. What is wind? What causes air to move? What is the meaning of wind currents? We have seen the wind current patterns like sea breeze and land breeze, as well as surface winds. Then we have talked about meaning of atmosphere and atmospheric pressure, and we discussed various factors affecting atmospheric pressure. Then we have seen one concept that high pressure winds are accompanied with low air pressure area. Okay. Then we have seen an instrument used to measure the wind speed, that is anemometer. Then we have discussed about three different types of storms: thunderstorms, cyclones, and tornadoes. And at the end of the lesson, we have just discussed the different weather precautions to be taken by government and people before, during, and after the storms.